Hi, community group leaders and teachers. I hope you're doing well and having a fabulous day. Hey, I'm excited to introduce this week's Leadership Minute. This is one more tool that you can have in your tool belt to lead more effectively. Over the last several weeks, we've been looking specifically at the power of prayer, how that is a tool we have in our tool belt as we intercede for those in our community group, looking for ways to highlight and call out strengths in individuals, to pray for God to help those individuals grow, even to pray for a couple people specifically, and ask for God to help them grow and how behind the scenes that can do incredible things. This week, I want to talk about another category of interceding for people within our community groups. And specifically, that is as we're praying for individuals, sometimes the Lord raises up specific issues that come to mind or impresses on us that we should specifically pray for one person or a couple of individuals to help them grow and to help them not go in a certain direction. You know, a couple of years ago, I was leading a college group for the church that I was involved in. And one of the college students behind the scenes was starting to entertain and struggling with pornography. I didn't know that. All I knew was that I felt like I was supposed to pray for the guy. So about a week went by and I felt heavily like I was supposed to pray for this young man. I ended up picking up the phone and calling him and saying, "Hey, can you tell me what's going on? What's happening?" And he confessed, "Well, yeah, this is what's been going on." And from that point, he and I came up with a plan to help him get back on track, but it never would have happened if I hadn't been obedient to start praying and interceding for God to encourage him and help him through the battle that I didn't even know what it was, but that he was walking through something, and then taking that next step to make the phone call. So my challenge to you is over the next week, pay attention to the voice of the Holy Spirit. As you're praying and interceding for people in your group, there might be somebody in your group that the Lord wants you to contact and reach out to say, "Hey, are you doing okay? I feel like I'm supposed to be praying for you. What specifically can I pray for you for?" Sometimes that'll lead to a conversation like I had with this young man who needed correction and who needed some help getting out of the ditch of pornography. Other times it might simply be that they just really needed encouragement, and you praying might be an act of encouragement for them, and knowing that God has highlighted someone to be praying for them might make all the difference in the world for them. So my encouragement to you is to pray and then be obedient to the voice of the Spirit this next week. If you have any questions about this Leadership Minute or any other topics we've covered over the last few weeks, reach out to me, shoot me an email, text, whatever. Hey, I am excited and thrilled that you continue to lead here at the church, and I want to be a partner and advocate with you as we lead together. Hope you have a wonderful day, friends. God bless.